IEnumerable can be a performance bottleneck to your application if not used properly. In today's video, first I'm going to show how implementing IEnumerable the incorrect way can cause a performance bottleneck. And after that, I'm going to show how the performance issue can be fixed easily by using IEnumerable the proper way. For the demonstration, I have come up with a use case where we are going to read user information from a database through a data access class. And the method of the data access class is the one which is going to return an IEnumerable. Now first, let's look into the database. And in the database, if you look into it, we have the name of the database is ecom. It has a user table. And the user table here has three columns, ID, name, and address. And I have pre-populated the database with four rows here. Now let's look into the data access class. And the name of the data access class is UserReader. The UserReader class has a method called readUsers, and this is where all the logic is going to be. So for the logic, what we are going to do is, inside of the UserReader, first we'll create a database connection using the connection string, which is passed as a dependency to the constructor of this class. So let's create the connection. So first we created a connection, and after creating the connection object, what we're going to do is we're going to create a SQL command to select the user ID, name, and address from the user table. Next, I'm just going to assign the command type to this command. So we can say command dot command type is equal to command type dot text. And once the SQL command is created, next, what we are going to do is we're going to open the connection. And for opening the connection, I'm going to just create a try catch block, because what we are going to do is it'll have a finally. So inside the try, we are going to have connection.open, and inside of finally, we'll have connection.close. And then inside the try, the first thing we are going to do is we are going to call the execute reader on the SQL command object, which will return a SQL reader. And after we got the SQL reader object, what we'll do is we'll create a while loop. And inside the while loop, we will call the read method on the SQL reader object. And inside the while loop, we will yield return the user object. So the user object that I have been talking about is nothing but a predefined user object model that I have created for a previous demo. And the user object or the user class here, as you can see, has ID, name, address. And apart from these three, which I'm going to use in this demonstration, it has few other attributes also, which are not important for this particular demonstration. We are going to focus only on these three. So let's get back to the user reader again. So we can do that. And here we're going to say ID is equal to reader.getInt0. And the name is equal to reader of get string of 1, and then address is equal to reader.get string of 2. Anytime we create an IEnumerable ourselves, we always have to do a yield return, because that is what provides the main behavior of IEnumerable, which is the deferred execution. Hence, in this method, the yield is causing a deferred execution, so it returns the IEnumerable. Now this class is ready. So we will go to the program class and use the user reader to show how it can cause a performance bottleneck in this implementation. And once I'm done showing that, I'll show how it can easily be resolved by using IEnumerable implementation in this kind of scenario correctly. So here first, what I am going to do is I'm going to create the user reader object. Expects the connection string. And for the connection string, what I have done is I have added the connection string into the environment variable, and I have saved the connection string with a key called connection string. So that is what I'm going to retrieve here. After the user reader is created, I am going to call the readUsers method of the user reader object, which is going to return the IEnumerable of user. After I get the users, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to create a for each loop, and for each user in the users, I'm going to write the name of the user in the console output. So I'm going to do console.writeLine, and here I'm going to do user.name. Now let's say I also want to print the ID of the user in the console, but I do not want to do it part of this loop. I want to do it as a separate loop. And this might be a real life scenario. You might be looping through the same collection multiple times inside the lifecycle of a method. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to again create another for each loop. Again, iterate through the users. And here, similarly, I'll have console.writeLine. And this time, I'm going to print out the user ID. Now I have two for each loop. Now first I'm going to put a breakpoint here where we are calling the read users. And then I'm also going to put a breakpoint here inside the read users method where we create the SQL connection. Now I'm going to run the application. And when I run the application, what is the usual expectation? The expectation is that readUsers is going to execute and it will return all the users from the database. And then we will just go through the same users in both the for each loop. But this is not going to be the true behavior. Instead, due to the nature of deferred execution behavior of the IEnumerable, we are going to see something completely different. So let me run the application now. And then once the application is started, I'm just going to do a F10 here. When I do an F10, you will see that it is not going inside the read users, but it will go inside the read user when we start looping through the IEnumerable. So the code execution does not happen during the read user call. Instead, it happens during the enumeration of the IEnumerable. So if I do this now, you can see it went inside. So here first we are going to create the SQL connection object, then the SQL command, and then open the SQL connection, call the execute reader, and inside while read, we are going to yield return the user. So if I do a F10 here, it comes inside and it prints out. Now if I do an F11 here, it will again go inside this yield return and come print the user, again F11, and you can see it is just inside the while loop, yielding the data, doing an yield return and printing things out. Next logical expectation is that the user's object already has all the user values. So when we do the loop again, it should just print it out from the in-memory. But now we can see that this is not the case. When we come here, and do an F10, it goes again inside the read users and it will go through the whole execution of database once again, and it will start doing the exact same thing, which is do a yield return of the data. And every time we do an F10, it is just going to yield return the rest of the data, and so on and so forth. Now, if I just do an F5, in the console, we can see the name and the IDs are printed as expected. So as you can understand, just returning an IEnumerable is causing us to connect to the database twice, which essentially is a performance issue. Plus, apart from just connecting to the database multiple times and slowing down the service, it is also going to consume more thread on the database, and it is going to add more load to the database as well. So the next question is, how do we solve this problem, or how can we use the IEnumerable properly? Well, we can just do one of two things. After we get the IEnumerable here, we can draw a dot to array or to list. Let's first try with to array. And what is going to happen when we do to array here is that it will force the iterator to execute as soon as this call is made and return the result. And as a result of that, the users array now will have all the users in memory. Hence, both the for each loop is going to print from the in-memory array instead of going to the database twice. So let's run this application and make sure this is working as I just explained. So now if I do an F10 here, now you can see it is going inside the read user and it is going through the database command. And here it will go through the entire while loop and yield return all the items. And now if we go to the user, we expand, we see the user object is populated. And at this point in time, if we do the for each loop here, we are not going to go back inside the read users anymore. And it is going to be same for both the for each. You can see it is not going inside the read users, which still have the breakpoint. So now I'll run this application, and in the output, we'll see the exact same behavior. And let's do the same thing. Instead of to array, let's just convert it to to list. And we should see the exact same behavior. So first time when we come inside the readUser.toList, we do a F10, it is going inside, and here it is going to iterate through the while loop. And after that, for the for each loop, it is not going inside the readUser method anymore. So this is the performance bottleneck we can face if we do not use the IEnumerable properly. One thing I just wanted to make sure I cover is that if the read user do not go and make a call to the database or any other IO operation which is going out of process, the performance hit is not going to be as severe as it is with going out of process into a database or a external HTTP service or something of that nature. For example, here, if we get rid of the SQL Server call and just define an in-memory user array, so if we have a user array like this, and let us get rid of this, and let's get rid of this connection.close, and here, instead of this while loop, we can just do for each, and var user in users, and here we can just return the user back. So if we just do that, and let us put a breakpoint here and then here, what we are going to see that now also in the read users, since we got rid of the to array, if we execute this read user, the for each, for both the for each, it is going to go inside the read user method and going to iterate, but it is not going to have as much as performance impact as going into a database because it is dealing with an in-memory array. So let me run this and show you. So once I run this, If I do a F10, it doesn't go to read users. Only when I iterate through, it goes inside read user, and it is going to do a yield return of user. And then again, second time, it will do a yield return of user. And then when I come to the next for each loop, the same thing is going to happen. It comes, it starts with the yield return, and then print, and then again, it is going to do a yield return here. So it is still going and executing the code of read user multiple times, but since we are not going outside of the process into a database or a cache or any other IO operations, it is not going to have as much bad performance implication as making an IO access call. That is all I wanted to cover for today's video. If you like this video, please click the like button. And if you are new to my channel and you think you are getting value out of my channel, please subscribe to my channel. And thanks so much for watching this video.